Today on 5-Minute Mondays, I'll explain when it's finally time to splurge on some pro audio editing software. Welcome to 5-Minute Mondays, where we bring you the best tips and strategies for building your podcast in 5 minutes or less. So if you're new here, consider subscribing. Now, when you're first getting started with your podcast, free software like Audacity and GarageBand are great places to start. They will give you the ability to record your audio, edit it in different tracks, apply some really basic settings and profiles and things like that. But you might be asking yourself, when is it time to buy a pro-level DAW or digital audio workstation? When is it time to take my editing game to the next level? And before I give you my answer, I want to tell you a story for myself of when I switched from editing movies in iMovie, which is the free software that you get on Apple devices like a MacBook, to Adobe's Premiere Pro. So when I was first getting started, I didn't have a lot of extra cash laying around. So I was like, well, if I want to start learning how to make movies just for fun, just to try it out, let me go ahead and use iMovie. And I learned a lot of the basics there. I learned how to cut different scenes. I learned how to transition. I learned how to add music beds. I learned how to add graphics and things on top of the video and picture in picture and those kind of things. And so when I was first getting started, it was helpful to not have a million options of things I could do. It was very simple software that allowed me to make basic videos. And I used that for over a year. And then I reached the point where it started holding me back. Like, I wanted to layer two things on top of a video and it would only let you do one. Or I wanted to add sound effects in addition to music, but there was only one track for that music. And so I was gonna have to create those custom tracks in GarageBand and then bring it into iMovie as an exported WAV file. And so I started hitting all these roadblocks where creatively iMovie could not do the things that I needed it to do. And that's when I decided to switch to Adobe Premiere Pro, which is a software that movie editors use for like blockbuster cinemas. So it's definitely like a super upgrade. And there was certainly a learning curve, but I was able to take all the skills I learned in iMovie and apply them to Premiere Pro. And within a couple months, I became pretty decent at using Premiere Pro to edit videos. And so I say that to say, when should you switch to another audio editing software? It's when your current software doesn't allow you to do what you want it to do. When it starts holding you back creatively, when you want to experiment with something in your episodes and your software isn't capable of doing that. So for example, when you want to dial in your compression settings just right, you're not looking for a dial that you just turn up and down, but you have a specific value in mind that you know is exactly the perfect compression for you and for your recording space. When you want to meticulously shape your fades and your crossfades, so you know exactly how you want the music to fade out, how you want the vocals to fade in, and it's not a straight line. When you want to really take it to the next level. Or when you want to create custom presets and voice profiles. So a lot of software is you can save voice profiles that will adjust the EQ of your voice to make it consistent. So if you record and you have a cold, you apply that voice profile and it makes it sound like you're perfectly healthy and you're not coughing up a lung. So those are all things that advanced audio editing softwares will allow you to do that the basic ones like GarageBand will not. And so when you find yourself in that place where you're wanting to push into those things, then that is when you should switch. If you are looking to upgrade, there are three programs that I recommend that I only hear great things about. The first one is Hindenburg Journalist Pro, which is an audio editing software specifically tailored for podcasters. If you're a Buzzsprout user, you can go into the resources section in your dashboard and there's actually a discount code. So you can do that if you want to try out Hindenburg Journalist Pro. The other two are Adobe Audition, which is great if you already use the Adobe Suite. You'll be very familiar with the layout. And then Logic Pro X, which is like GarageBand on steroids. But I've been podcasting for years and I'm still using GarageBand. So don't feel like you have to upgrade to one of these pro audio editing suites to feel like a real podcaster, because you can make incredible podcast episodes simply using the free tools that are already available to you. Well, that's it for today. Hit the subscribe button if you're watching this on YouTube, or subscribe to the 5-Minute Mondays podcast in your favorite app to squeeze even more podcast-related content into your life. And if there's something you want me to talk about on a future episode, you can click the link in the show notes to submit your question. Thanks for listening, and as always, keep podcasting.